evolving and transforming butterflies. It's your best friend in the whole world, Rachel, and I'm here to give you news, tips, updates, and more in Cliniko this week. While the holiday season is officially over, a lot of you may have picked up a new Apple device, specifically a new iPhone or iPad Pro. So this week, I wanted to share with you two handy tips that would help you get up and running on your new device, specifically how to add a shortcut to Cliniko on your home screen, as well as addressing the big question for iPad Pro users. Does Apple Pencil work with Cliniko? First, let's add a shortcut to Cliniko so it appears on the home screen like your other apps. I'm using an iPad Pro on iOS 11 for this, so while this can be done on older and, of course, new devices, the location of some of these icons may be different for you. To get started, open Cliniko and log in if you haven't already via the Safari app. Then, navigate to the page you'd like to have Cliniko open to each time. Then, click the share icon that looks like a rectangle with an arrow pointing up. You'll then select Add to Home Screen. Type in the name of your Cliniko account, or just Cliniko. Then click Add. You'll then see the icon appear on your home screen. Now you won't have to use a bookmark or type in your Cliniko URL every time you want to use Cliniko on your Apple device. Just note, there isn't a way to add to the home screen using Chrome on Apple devices, but you can add a shortcut to the home screen from Chrome on Android devices. Now let's address the question of the day. What about Apple Pencil? Specifically, can you use Apple Pencil with Cliniko and writing treatment notes? Right now, Apple does not have any features that will allow you to write instead of using the keyboard when filling out a text box on Safari or Chrome, including any text boxes that appears on treatment notes, letters, patient detail pages, etc. That said, there are of course a number of third-party apps that allow you to handwrite your notes using the pencil or stylus or even your finger, which then transforms into text. And while there isn't one application that I would recommend over the others, whatever you decide to use, do not enable full access. For example, my Script Stylus is an app that installs a third-party keyboard that allows you to handwrite using the Apple Pencil, a stylus, again, even your fingers. But when installed, they request full access, which grants the permission to use or share what you write with their developers, including passwords, credit card details, everything. But just know, this is optional. You can keep the access restricted and use the application without sharing what you're writing, including your treatment notes. So keep this off and you're good to go. Now, what do you do when you find an application that you want to use? When you have installed the third-party keyboard app, you'll want to first add it as a new keyboard via the Settings app. Head over to General, Keyboard, Keyboards, then click Add a New Keyboard. Select the app you just installed. So for me, it was my Script Stylus. Then when you're in Cliniko, you can switch to this new keyboard by holding the globe icon. Select the new stylus, which again for me is my Script, then write away. When you're done, you can switch back to the Apple keyboard by either tapping that globe icon or again, holding it down. So while Apple does not have this feature built in, there are a number of apps that support handwriting to text. So feel free to find one that you're comfortable with. The same can be said for any Apple device and even Android devices. Both have apps that support handwriting to text. Not all of them require the Apple Pencil either. Also, this is a secret between you and me, but body diagram charts, once released, will allow the use of the Apple Pencil for drawings or any handwritten notes you'd like to add to your diagram. No ETA on the release date, but let me know if you'd like to see a preview of what's coming for body diagrams. Well, that's it for this week's episode. Also, let me know if you found any additional tips for using Cliniko on a mobile or tablet device. Until next time. Bye!